people. Good day, great day, graceful day. We've got ourselves a Sylvie on. G-Day to you people, and welcome to episode number 5 of the Pokémon Alpha Sapphire Egglocke. If you guys are excited for the episode coming up ahead, and the rest of the Let's Play to come, make sure you hit the like button down below for us, because as always, your support is greatly appreciated. In the last episode, you guys, we got ourselves the second gym badge, and we had a moment of stupidity, which did cost us our first death in this Let's Play. A big apology to Mokujin, because he did not deserve to go in that way. But, unfortunately, we can't sit and memorialize our dear Mokujin. But we have to move forward, and we've got a new member in our team. It's going to be Angry Bug the Heracross. You would have seen that tiny montage at the start of this episode where we got ahead, went back to all the trainers at the start of Sleepwalk City, and we got ourselves Angry Bug trained up a bit, basically a few trainers, almost dying to a Goldeen. That was pretty hilarious. And also finding the Alakazite that was in the market area. So today, hopefully we'll get to Mauville City, but I'm not too sure if we will face the gym leader, because what I'll do today is I'll go to all the neighboring areas around Verunto, like Verunto City and the other route there, get our encounters, and then maybe we can hatch some more eggs in this episode, and then we'll train up our Pokemon, because I know that Watson has level 21, I believe is his highest. He's got a Magneton 21, Voltorb, and a Magnemite, both level 18, as far as I know. But let's go ahead and take a look at our episode. Let's have a look at our team, and let's have a look at our party over here. So, we've got ourselves Angry Bug, the newest member of our team, the Heracross, with Horn Attack, Aerial Ace, Mega Horn, and Rock Blast. So, I'll keep Rock Blast on so that when we do get the Mega Ring, we can actually use Mega Heracross. That would be awesome. Then we've got Sharpino the Dino with Bite, Dragon Rage, Head Smash, and Earth Power. Then we've got Palm Springs the Leap with Confuse Ray, Rock Tomb, Acid, and Ingrain. Princess Ice Marwile, another Mega Potential, with Bite, Fairy Wind, Rock Tomb, and Sucker Punch. Graceful the Sylveon with Quick Attack, Tackle, Fairy Wind, Charm, who took the second gym by storm. And finally, we have Chris the Fioni with Bubble, Water Sport, and Charm. So because Angry Bug is, in fact, our weakest Pokemon, we will go ahead and start things off. Now, I did skip the Pokemon contest segment with that chick who gives us the contest block and pass everything else, because I don't give a crap about that kind of shit, you know what I'm saying? Okay, so here we are on Route 110. Now, I'm pretty sure this is all 110 here. I always forget to get the Word document up for this here. Why do I always do that? So, Route 110. So, we have got an encounter for Route 110. But we'll go ahead and see what you do.
You just keep going through Route 110 and head to Mount Chimney.
Wow, that's quite far. Why don't we take a rest in Mauville City? It's on the way.
Yeah.
Great idea. Great idea.
Okay, so obviously up to no good, no good, no good. Delightful Pokemon. Oh boy, let's have a look at this delightful Pokemon. Oh boy, that's going to be a Plusle. Now let's check out the levels of these Pokemon as well, because I know that we're going to take on a Combusken as well. So that's it, that's level 15. So, okay, so our Pokemon are actually on par with the trainer's Pokemon. Which means that the Pokemon that when we go to head to those Mei on this route, we could have some problems. That's definitely our potential. So, what I might do is, I might go ahead and start training on Chris, because Chris is going to be our answer for that, the Combusken. Because that Combusken, I believe, is level 18. And like I said, Chris being our more probable answer for that. I've got a feeling that we might have another death. I don't want to have another death, because, I mean, look, if we have another death, we have another death, but I just don't want to have a death from stupidity like the last episode, because that was totally ridiculous. It was really, I mean, it was so unlike me to let something stupid like that happen. That's just my opinion. Whether you choose to believe that or not, that is entirely up to you. But if you guys watch me long enough, you know that I'm cool, calm, and calculated. Like, I try to make all these predictions long and way ahead before anything else happens.
Oh! Did you feel the tug of our soul-soothing fragrance?
Get off the drugs, man! Look at that, marijuana floating all around. And we've got a Roselia, which Chris does not like at all. So, We're going to go ahead, level 17, those levels are starting to climb up. Alright, so let's go ahead and let's swap out for Sharpino. Because Sharpino got that Dragon Rage boy, take out anything. So really, if he goes with, yeah, Grass type move, that should, wow. Okay, so Roselli obviously has a little special attack. Let's go ahead and go for a Dragon Rage, let's see how much damage it does. Will it be enough to take out the Roselli? And she has speed does, like what the fuck? Alright, so we're going for Dragon Rage, and it's going to just miss out on the KO, so that's unfortunate, that is unfortunate. But she's going to waste a turn going for Leaf Seed, which is good for us, if we can land this bite. Of course we would miss the bite, what the fuck, okay. This is not cool at all. Not cool, man, not cool. So we're going to go for another bite. God, this Roselia is really annoying right now. Like, get the fuck, GTFO, get out. And down goes Roselia. Alright. Man, we're trying to champ Chris here, we don't have time for your bullshit. Wow, 510 experience, good god. Quite the chunk of experience, so to speak. So, Sharpino's now level 16, which is good that we got him up there as well. But we're going to continue going, Alright, so Palm Springs is actually our next, or well, it's still up front. So let's keep, let's go for a double battle with Chris and, Palm Springs. I say, why not? Mindlip and Plusle, helping hands, just trying to help each other out. Alright, so the question today is, and this is a pretty good question, what is your favorite? The level 16. Ugh, we can't risk that. We'll go ahead and we'll swap out for Angry Bug because Angry Bug resists the electric. I was gonna go for an attack, but Chris is a little bit underleveled and I want to take a double spark anytime soon. So we'll go for a Rock Tomb with Palm Springs. Swap out. Okay, so question of the day is, what is your favorite shiny Pokemon? So, obviously you guys know Red being my favorite Pokemon. Any Pokemon with the potential to be a Red Pokemon is my absolute favorite. And there you go. Wow, he doesn't actually resist the... But okay, we're going to go for a double attack on this Plusle. And we missed the Mega Horn. What the fuck, dude? Seriously, what is this bullcrap? Wheeling down that Plusle. Let's go ahead and go for a Mega Horn. Hopefully we can land it. And we'll go for a... What the hell? What the hell? Dude! Mega Horn, get your freaking... Oh, God. Angry Bug, get your shit together. Like, dude. Third time's a motherfucker charm! Ah! Down goes the Plusle. Alright, so favorite shiny, back to the original question. Now, I won't lie, shiny Hydreigon does not look good at all. I appreciate where they were trying to go with the purple and the green, but I really don't like it, to be honest with you. I just don't. So let's see, favorite shinies. I do like shiny Steelix Gold looks amazing, even though it's Steelix, so it kind of defeats the purpose, unless it was like Goldix or something, but then that just sounds gay as fuck. The favorite shinies, I do like shiny Metagross, that looks amazing with the yellow cross in the middle, and it's got like a more chrome kind of look on the steel look, because it looks more like a light steel kind of look, which does look pretty good. I like shiny Registeel, that looks amazing. Shiny Registeel green metal, that's just how good it is. Okay, now I think we're going to go ahead and start healing up some... Well, actually, no. Only Heracross and Dana have taken damage. The Leap Palm Springs remained untouched in that battle. So yeah, that's my answer. Megadigross and Registeel. Put a comment down below and tell me what your favorite shinies are. As far as favorite non-legendary shinies, what is a good shiny that looks good? Actually, Pinsir. Mega Pinsir shiny looks amazing af. And shout out to A-Drive because that was his sprite at one point with, you know, shiny Mega Pinsir. Mega Pinsir looks shiny and sexy af. But alright, so we got a Skitty here. Let's go for a bubble. We're gonna get slapped around with that tail. I whip my tail back and forth, I whip my tail, and crits gets one extra damage. Fuck you. Alright, so, yeah. Leave a comment down below, tell me what your favorite shiny is. Tell me down below also, you know, how you guys are doing, because as always, I like to take an interest in your guys' lives, what you guys are doing. And we're just going to get sung to sleep, which is pretty bad. I don't like it. But the one thing I like about Fiony is that wherever he goes, or wherever it goes, it's going to be happy because he knows that he's a Fiony. That's why he's like, hey. Just like me, boy, Ski, it's not even stabbed. Get out of here. See, look at that. He's happy, even asleep. But we wake up after one turn of sleep. There you go! There you go! And down goes the Skitty. It's actually pretty hot today. You know, it's summer in Australia. Like, our summer's like the opposite. Our seasons are the opposite of America. So, in December through to February, it's our summer, as opposed to America being their winter, and vice versa. Autumn, spring, same flippity flu. So, a fisherman. Ha 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 ha. Alright, so we've got another fisherman here, two Pokemon, and it's a
Magikarp. Magikarp. Magikarp.
Go, Chris! So, Chris is level 17, he's looking pretty powerful now. We'll try to get him a bit up there because, like I said, the combustion is level 18, and I know it does have access to Double Kick, Ember, Sand Attack, and I don't know, Quick Attack or Tackle, it's one of the two, but I know it's going to be trouble for us if we do. Now, this Magikarp's going to have an offensive attack. It's Tackle. So, we've got the speed reduction, irrelevant because we do our speed. What's the point of splashing, Magikarp? I don't know, looking at you, I'm getting a bit hungry for sushi now. Because sushi is one of my favorite foods. I do love sushi. Seriously, my favorite sushi has to be scallop. I don't know why, just scallop is just an amazing sushi. And you eat it with chopsticks. Now, I don't eat the soy sauce and wasabi. I haven't actually tried that. Now, a lot of people keep telling me to try it, but I enjoy the flavors of the sushi too much to want to, I wouldn't say ruin it, but I'd say overpower the flavor of the scallop. So, yeah. Leave a comment down below if you love sushi, or if you don't like sushi, tell me why. So, we're going to proceed through here. We're going to, I think this lady isn't a trainer.
I don't have a bike, so I take the low road.
Yeah, that sucks for you. Alright, so we're going to quickly go back to the Pokemon Center. Heal up. Actually, we might as well get our encounter here. Let's go ahead and get an encounter for Route 110. Our encounter is going to be a
Electric!
It's Electric. Coolies. Level 11. So let's go ahead and, Palm Springs doesn't have a lot of offensive. I mean, it's got acid, so it's not a stab move. So we can try to whittle down this Electrike just a tinsy bit. Just a tinsy bit. And that Quick Attack is going to do absolutely nothing because we are Palm Springs. Let's go ahead and go for an acid. Electrike, what are you doing, buddy? You know you can't touch Palm Springs. We're grass and we're rock, so you can't touch this. So we're going to go for more acid and hopefully we don't crit and we can get Electrike. Now we have ourselves two encounters that we have yet to replace. There we go. Alright, so let's go ahead now, reaching our bag of Okay, so luckily we checked our supplies. We actually do need to get some Pokeballs. So it's a good thing that, yeah, no, we didn't get anything good. So 1, 2, and 3. Perfect. So that's one note we're going to make. So we got ourselves Route 110, we got Electrike. Okay, so now we've got two Eggsmen to replace. We've still got one more Magikarp left to replace. And we have this Electrike here that we do have to go ahead and swap out for an egg. Now, we'll actually do that a bit later on the episode. We'll continue going through this route here, take on May, and get some business dealt with. That's how we do it. Unfortunately, we haven't seen a lot of Heracross this episode. I'm really sorry about that. But after we verse May, we definitely will bring out Angry Bug to take on random encounters and trainers that are coming up. Because I do know that there's a Nerd and there's a Psychic coming up, and Heracross will have a fun time versing them. I can tell you that much. But Yeah, nah, just totally bummed about Mokuji, man. We could have had a Grovyle right now, we could have trained him up, and we'd be on our way to make a Sceptile, and it was coincidental, it was serendipitous, using that word knowledge of mine, that we had swapped out our Hoenn starter and we got the other Hoenn starter. Funnily enough, yeah, like, I don't know, out of the three of them, I don't know, like, I love, out of the three Hoenn starters, I like Torchic, I love Mudkip, but if I had to say which one of them was my least favourite, I would probably have to say Treecko. Like, I know Treecko Sceptile is awesome, but, like, Blaziken and Swampert are actually, I feel they're better Pokemon than Sceptile. That's just my opinion. Not saying that it's bad because I said that, but I just personally feel of the three of them, if I had to pick my least favourite, it would be that one. Now, obviously because Blaziken gains speed boost, obviously it is pretty powerful, but the fact that, you know, Mega Swampert, you know, has such a good widespread move pool and you know, just Rain Dance, and it's just the fastest thing on the field. Like, it's just pretty cool like that. Ah, but we have Electrike here. Should we? Yeah, we'll stay in. We'll test the limits. We'll go for a bubble on Electrike. Let's see how much damage it does for Electrike. It does well over half. Does for a spark. Let's see how much damage it does. Okay, so it does a little bit of damage. Doesn't get the paralysis. Very good, very good. We can actually take an Electrike. But we're just trying to make sure that we got ourselves Chris leveled up here. You know, Chris, you know, being the guy that I am, try to, you know, be the best I can. And we see an Aaron. Ooh, it's an Aaron. Oh, that's actually, now I see that. Shiny Aggron is also amazing. I don't know why I have this fascination with Steel-type Pokemon, even though my favorite type is Dark. I like Dark, Fire, and Steel. They were my three favorite types. So, yeah. Least favorite type? Trying to think what's my least favorite type. Ah, there's May, so let's go ahead and use a potion to heal up here. There we go, there we go, there we go. Hey, May.
Hi, Sharpino. It's been ages.
Well, for us, it's a few episodes, but...
Nice talking too. I was just searching for Pokemon, you know? My dad is always going on about how nature used to be even more diverse way back in the day. He says that there used to be way more kinds of Pokemon than there are now.
Ah, I get it. Yeah, gotcha.
So that's why we need to do field work, him and me. We really want to find out what happened to those Pokemon in the past. On my journey up to now, I've met a lot of different Pokemon, and I think I've got to understand a lot of them too. Me and my Pokemon have really grown. So, how about a little battle?
Without even saying yes, but here we go. We've got ourselves our battle with Tranemay. Let us see here with the Slugma. So that's perfect for our first Pokemon. So she starts with a Slugma, we got Chris up front, we're going to have a fun time. Because Slugma has absolutely no defenses whatsoever, well, special defense wise. Wow, I miscalculated. That Slugma is actually level 18, which means that that Combusken, I think, will be level 20. Oof. Oof. And down goes the Sluggy. Bloody Mary, throw it back to last. And next is Grobot. Oh, that's right, we picked Master. Okay, well, that's another miscalculation on our part. Forgetting that we picked the Mudkip, so her Pokemon would be Grobot, not, you know. But now we've trained up Angry Bug just a teensy bit now, because now our Angry Bug is a bit unleveled. But let's go ahead and go for a Mega Horn. Let's see how much damage this Mega Horn does to this Grobot. Now I'm upset because we could have had a Grovyle. Me and Mabel. Oh my damn! Grovyle doesn't stand a chance. Angry Bug in the house, people. Oh my damn! Mega Bug, Angry Bug, Chip Away. Yeah, let's take over Horn Attack and kill you, Chip Away. Chip Away has more base power than Horn Attack, so why the hell not? But god damn, he just demolished that Grovyle right there. Oh. Oh yeah, because Chris was already in here. Alright, let's go for another Mega Horn, see how much damage it does to a Wailmer. Wow, that does a lot. Oh, here we go. Rolly, 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 rolly. Let's go for a Chip Away and take out this Wailmer. Down goes the Wailmer. Look at that small. Down it goes. But we defeated May. Great. I was actually a little bit worried about it, but
yikes, I knew you'd be stronger, but man. Sharpino, you've been busy training too, haven't you? Oops, but look at that teams look pretty tired.
My team's all freaking blazing, I don't know about you, your Pokemon sucks.
Let's get taking care of that first. How is it everyone has the ability to heal Pokemon? Teach me how to do that so I can heal my Pokemon wherever I go.
And now I think you deserve a reward too. It's Mr. for me.
So we'll go down the machine now, we can find hidden items, great.
Try now if there's a hidden item where you can use it to find it. Pay attention and lead you the right to items. And it's fun to see all those waving bits around your head. Try it and I bet you'll be hooked. Careful, you won't be able to sneak up and poke me while you wear it. See you later, Sharpino. Let's meet again. I hope we'll both be able to meet even more Pokemon in our journeys.
Well, I'm pretty sure. Hey, where's the bike? Give me the bike! Oh, wait, we're heading for it. Alright, so let's go ahead and put Angry Bug out front now because Angry Bug just demolished that team right there. The Palm Springs is looking a little bit on the low side. So let's go ahead and put Palm Springs out front because Angry Bug is just demolishing this, demolishing the team, the trainers and Pokemon right here. But we're going to encounter, it's going to be a
Electric.
Go, Palm Springs. Try to get all our Pokemon on the same par, on the same level. We might have another grinding montage because I know that the Pokemon coming up are going to be a little bit difficult. But I don't know, like, we're at level 18s at the moment. Like, our highest level Pokemon is, I think it's Sharpino, level 18. I can't remember shit. Is it Graceful or Chris is level 18. So that's our highest level Pokemon. So if we get everyone up to level 18, then we should be A-OK. But he's a nerd.
Could I see your Pokemon? Just one look, please.
But you challenge us to a battle anyway. Like this. Yeah, that's a pretty badass pose with the Pokeballs like that. You can just like throw it out like that. You know, that is pretty cool.
Lombre!
Go, Palm Springs! So we've both got neutral grass hits coming our way, but let's go ahead and go for a Confuse Ray. That's fine, you're gonna growl, that's fine. We're not playing to rock tomb you, but what I was trying to do was I was gonna ask you because you are a grass type, which means poison will rape you. We're gonna go for an acid. Lombre's confused but goes for absorb. Ah, you bitch. It was a critical hit! But acid goes through, does a little bit of damage because it's not stabbed, which is unfortunate, but still confused. Can you hit yourself? There you go. Drop that acid on you. Woo! One more acid should do the trick, peoples. Snapped out, does a few swipes, misses it because he's on tripping on acid, and you drop the acid, and down goes the Lombre. Next up,
Nuzleaf.
Same deal, we'll go for another acid. It's growthing up. Now, I can't remember if Dark resists poison. No, it doesn't. Okay, great.
Nuzleaf!
Whoa, that did a lot of damage. Wait, 41, that's 16 damage. So we should be fine, we should live one more. Nature power turns to energy. Oh no! Oh! Whoa! Shit! We almost lost Palm Springs, holy fuck! Cool nerd, I like you guy. Alright, so we'll quickly go ahead and heal up, you know, because we were smelling death right there in the face.
Fuck me.
Let's continue. Psychic, I have foreseen your intentions. I cannot possibly lose. Is that so, eh? Let's see what Psychic type Pokemon you'd be gracing us with your presence. An Abra. And this Abra is doing jack shit. This Abra is just going to be teleporting because it's the only goddamn move he can learn. Rock Tomb. And whoa. Whoa! What the fuck? He has hidden power? So wait, what's super effective you get fighting? That's hidden power fighting. Oh, what a... We went from 49 to 27. So we should be able to live one more. We're going to go for a Rock Tomb. There we go. And Palm Springs is just hanging in there. Oh my gosh. Man. This is bullshit, man. Fuck, he had hidden power. Well, I mean, I know it doesn't learn it by level up, but damn, they put Pokemon with added moves because they knew that he would only have teleport, but fuck me! Alright, so let's go ahead and put Princess Ice up front, because now Princess Ice is a bit on the low scale for levels, so we'll try to get her up a bit of levels here.
It's a Plusle!
Drop that Intimidate so you can't touch this. Well, you can still touch us, but you're not going to do too much. So let's go ahead and go for a Fairy Wind. Stab. Wow, that did nothing. Okay. Excuse me. Don't know why I keep burping. Burping, slurping. Alright, so it looks like one more Fairy Wind is going to be enough to take out this Plusle. Mate, you ain't doing nothing to Princess Light. She's too powerful. Power! Oh! The power of Princess Ice. Level 16. There we go. So all our Pokemon now are level 16 and above. If we can get some offensive moves... Hey, don't stick at me while I'm fishing! I just did, so fuck you. Alright, so Fisherman here with the...
Tentacool.
Now, Princess Ice is not going to have any problems because... Even though it is weak to poison, we are steel type, which means we can't be touched by poison. Let's go ahead and go for a rock tomb. Constrict. Muddy! Because the clear body is not going to lose any speed. Toxic spike come through. That's not nice. Down goes the
tentacle.
Whalemur! Let's go for a Fairy Wind. Let's see how much damage a Fairy Wind. It's going to astonish us. Oh, I'm so surprised. Fairy Wind goes and do a little bit of damage. Let's go for a Sucker Punch, see if that does more damage. Yeah, that does a lot more damage. His mouth looks funny. Sucker Punch coming through. Goodbye, Whalemur. And it almost gets the level up. Unfortunately, just misses out. But, it's all good in the hood. Two roads to pick from. Ah, yes. Wouldn't it be great if I can get a sucker and get a bike? Then you go up there, kiddo. Ah, Wally. Now, we haven't done a voice for Wally because I skipped this part. So let's go ahead and think of a good voice for Wally here. Let me think.
So this is Mauville City.
You sure seem to be enjoying it, Wally. So what would you like to do? Do you want to grab a bite to eat at the Mauville food court? Or maybe we should get you a bike for your owner, ride or cycle. Would you like that? I bet the exercise would be good for your health.
No thank you. I want to challenge the gym right away.
What?
Let me see. I'm pretty sure the gym is... Yep. Straight up ahead this way. Just through the inner courtyard.
Hey, what? Hey, wait up. Wally? Wally getting a bit too excited. But what I think we would do is... We'll go ahead and, we'll heal up and then we'll face Wally. And then what I'll do is, after we face Wally, we'll go ahead and start hatching some eggs. Because what we can do is, we can have another bit of a montage, so to speak. We'll get our encounter. We can get our encounter for the areas. And then what I'll do is I'll train up all the Pokemon versus the trainers in a montage. I don't know if you guys hate the montage or anything, but I'm just trying to make sure that you guys know that I'm doing everything by the books. You guys know that I'm training all my Pokemon. So if you guys don't like the montages, let me know. But if you guys like the montages, I'll keep them up.
Uncle, I'm begging you. I want to challenge this gym, see how strong I become. Freeze, you'd let me, won't you?
Now, hold on, Bobby. It's certainly true that you've grown quite a lot stronger alongside your Pokemon. But don't you think that jumping right into the challenging a gym might be pushing it?
I'm not pushing it. If me and my Ralts, we could be anyone. A Sharpino, roll
since we first met. Growing together, I want to prove that to you and my uncle both, Sharpino. Please, tell me once more, and have a battle with me.
Yeah, well, no, we'll help the kid out.
Oh, thank you, Sharpino. Okay, here we go. We're gonna win this, Ralts. We have to. Ugh.
So we got ourselves a battle, and you guys will know that Nexus was a bit responsible for that voice, and watching him do it on Surgeons, I was pissing myself laughing every time he did the auger yearn when he kept doing it. So, Ralts against Princess Ice. So we're going to have a good matchup here because we do have a nice little circle punch. Nice little circle punch. But he's going to get the lucky chance. God dang it! You're in your lucky chance. Stop it! Attack me! Teleport. Attack me! Did he only have access to Lucky Chan teleport? Well, fine, fuck you, I'll go for Rock Tomb. Oh, of course, now he would go for Magical Leaf the second I swap moves. Fuck you! Fuck you! Keep going for this, reducing the speed. Magical Leaf's gonna go through here. I didn't even know what the hell that was, I just heard something. I apologize. Let's go ahead and go for a bite, and this bite should be enough to take out the Ralts. So, skippy skippy. Okay. Level 17. Whoop 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 whoop! What's learning Vice Grip? Now, let's have a look at the base power of Vice Grip. That's 55, 60, 60, 40, but it's stab, so. Nah, we're not gonna teach you Vice Grip. I know you've got that giant mouth behind you, but we're not going to teach you Vice Grip. There's no point. There's no point.
Wow, you're really a strong Sharpino.
Sorry, kiddo. You challenge a good trainer, you're going to have a good battle.
Uncle, I'll go back to Burden Turf. Sharpino, thank you. Being a trainer is tough, isn't it? It's not enough just to battle with your Pokemon. I can't become a true trainer like that. Not really.
Wally, there's no need to get so down yourself. Why, what's keeping you from becoming stronger? Nothing is. All you need to do is keep growing. Come on, let's go home. Everyone's waiting for you.
Yes, Uncle. Sharpino?
Yes?
I'm gonna get stronger. Much, much stronger. I feel like I learned a lot from just one Pokemon battle with you. About my own limits and Ralts's.
That's true. You do learn a lot from every battle.
So, that's why, Sharpino, if it's alright, could I call you my rival? Never mind. Sorry, it was nothing. Please forget about it. Goodbye.
Hey. It just dawned on me that you must be the young man who kept an eye out for Wally when he caught his Pokemon. So it's you we have to thank for Wally becoming so positive about his future. Thank you. Ah, here, take this. I want you to have it as a bit of a thank you.
So we've got HMS6 Rock Smash. So,
even if there's obstacles in your path, I think you'll be able to break through them. Especially if you use Rock Smash there. Well, we should head back now, but if you ever have the time, I'd love it if you stopped by our home in Vernon Turf. I'm sure Wally would enjoy it too. We look forward to seeing you. Goodbye.
Alright, so what we're going to do is, we're going to get all our encounters now for the areas all around us. Because I think that would be a good thing to do. And then, like I said, we'll have a montage where we take on all the trainers. That are out and about here. Alright, so let's go ahead and get our trusty rod out. We got a wild one. And we got ourselves a
Magikarp. Magikarp.
Magikarp. Magikarp. Now, at level 15 now. Ooh, this is really cool. Now, I'm just trying to think what would be the best move. Let's go for a Rock Tomb. Hopefully Rock Tomb isn't going to kill it. Because it's not stab. and we get a speed drop, so it makes catching up a little bit easier. Okay, good. Let's go ahead and try and... So, oh my god, we didn't shop for Pokeballs. God damn it, we didn't shop for Pokeballs. Now we're going to waste a Great Ball on the Magikarp. One, two, three. Alright, so we got ourselves a Magikarp. Now we actually need to go ahead and shop for some Pokeballs because we need some Pokeballs. Gotta get some Pokeballs, gotta get some Pokeballs, gotta get them Pokeballs. Now, I'm just trying to figure out what area I'll be in because we're at 118. Let's go ahead and at the word document, we got ourselves a Magikarp for like the fifth time so far, which is irrelevant because, like I said, we're just gonna swap out these Pokemon anyway. Alright. So, goody, goody, goody. Alright, so we're now going to head back. We're going to head now to the other side after we buy some Pokeballs, of course, because we need to buy some. We're in dire need of it. We'll buy some Pokeballs and some Great Balls. We'll go 10 Pokeballs, get a Premier Ball, and we'll go 10 Great Balls. And we're going to buy some Super Potions as well. Let's go 10. Enough. Wow, 7,000. Look at that money just drop like a boss. Alright, so now we'll head over to the... Actually, no. We'll go ahead and get the bike. That's actually the one thing we forgot to do. Because that bike is going to be making hatching eggs so much easier. So much easier. Like, you wouldn't believe. I'm trying to think.
Cling, cling. Well, well. What do we have here? A most energetic customer. Me? You may call me Rival. I'm the owner of the cycle shop. Your running shoes, they're awfully filthy. Did you come from far away?
Well, yes I did. I come from all the way from Little Red City, Little Red Town.
You said you came all the way from Little Red? My goodness, that's ridiculously far. If you had one of my bike, you could go anywhere easily while feeling the gentle caress of the wind. I'll tell you what, I'll give you a bike. Oh, wait a second. I forgot to tell you that there are two kinds of bikes. There's the Mark bike and the Acro bike. Mark bikes are for cyclists who want to feel the wild blowing wind as they ride. Acro bikes are those who prefer a technical ride. I'm a real sweetheart, so you can have whichever one you want. If you're a real sweetheart, you're giving us both bikes. So which one would you choose? Let's go with the Mark bike, because we need some speed to hatch these eggs. If you get the urge to switch bikes, just come and see me.
Alright, so let's go ahead and register the bike. Let's go gliding and flying. Whee! Now hatching eggs will be a bit of a breeze and not so much of a drag. Alright, so now we're in this area and this is Route 117. The train isn't it? The encounter for Route 117 is going to be a Rosalia. A beautiful Rosalia. Now that's level 12, so once again we'll go for a rock tomb because it shouldn't do too much. Ah, oh, god damn it. Rock tomb. In the yellow, we'll go ahead and go for a fairy wind because fairy wind is resisted. So one more fairy wind, put in the red, and then we'll go ahead and try to catch it. But I think we're going to need a Great Ball for this one because he's raising, that growth is raising not only its attack but its special attack as well. Alright. What am I doing? Alright, so let's go ahead and go to a bag and let's grab a Great Ball. And use a Great Ball on this Rosalia. Because I've got a feeling that those growthing is actually going to make it hard to catch. One, two, and three. Or maybe not. Maybe not. Rosalia. So that's an encounter for Route 117, and once again we now have three Pokemon that we need to go ahead and replace. There we are, Mundo Randomizer. Great job. You want nickname is Rosalia? Hell no! Yay, upload's coming. Yay, you've been uploading the video this whole time. So the training for the later is okay. Alright, so let's go ahead and get a number between 1 and 63. Let's get the number generated. So we can go ahead and replace some Pokemans.
So let's go ahead and see which Pokemon we have to go ahead and replace first. First off, let's get our catching crew together, or our hatching crew together. So we'll put you two down there at the moment. Put you at the top. Alright, so... actually, we've got four Pokemon we need to replace. Oh, goodness. Okay. So we've got this Magikarp, then Electrike, then this Magikarp, and then the Roselia. Alright, so let's go ahead. We're going to replace... wait. We're at 1 and 9, so we've got to replace this Magikarp first. So this is going to be over here. Alright, so we're going to replace Magikarp level 10. Let's get the number randomizer going. And the number is going to be... number 42. And it was sent in by another random passerby with the name Petite Arc. So let's go ahead and go to number 42. So 36, 42. So now let's go ahead and see what egg number 42 is. Thank you very much, Petite Arc, for your donation. If you got Shiny Dialga's for eggs, that was me. So we'll be right back to go ahead and see what this random egg is sent in by Petite Arc. We'll be right back. Okay, so we're back, and this egg didn't take very long to hatch, so thank you, Petite Arc, for making this egg easy to hatch. But let's go ahead and see what we're going to replace our Magikarp with. No nicknames, we have no idea what it's going to be. And the egg is going to be a... ooh, it's gonna be a Rhyhorn. I've had a Rhydon on two of my Let's Plays already, so this is actually pretty on par with everything else. Ah, you stupid computer, shut up. God damn. Alright, so what's a good name for a Rhydon? Let's call it the first Rhydon that we had, Drillrun. Drillrun the Rhydon. That's actually a good name. I like that. Alright, so let's go ahead and check out this Rhydon. Drillrun the Rhydon, flashback to the first Let's Play. It's got a sassy nature, so that's very good. And a Horntack and Tail Whip. So that's not a bad Rhyhorn, to say the least. So now let's go ahead now and put that in the PC. Let's go ahead, red candied up to level 10, because that's what we're replacing it with. Level 10. Yeah, so Rhyhorn, it's always interesting to get Pokemon that you've used on prior Let's Plays. We had Rhydon the Shotlock, we had Rhydon in my first Let's Play, the Fire Red Randomizer, so it's always good when you get little Pokemon that you've had flashbacks Let's Plays with, but I would say Rhyhorn's probably the most commonly used Pokemon I would say on my Let's Plays, so learn Fury Attack and Scary Face. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and put him in the PC. Thank you, Petite Arc, for that one. Passerby Petite Arc. Next up we're going to replace is a level 11 Electrike. Let's go ahead and get the number randomizer going. And the number's going to be number 36. We've already had that one. Number... 45, we already had that one. 30! Number 30! Let's see what number 30 is. Number 30 was sent in by... Sean Hendershot with the nickname T.O.G. which he says stands for The Other Guy. And he has a YouTube channel, so go ahead and check out his YouTube channel, The Other Guy. So let's go ahead and replace it with egg number 30. It's the last egg in this box here. So let's go ahead and see what egg number 30 is going to be. We'll be right back to find out what this egg is going to be. Okay, we're back. Egg's ready to hatch. Thanks from The Other Guy. Go ahead and check out his YouTube channel. It's Sean Hendershot with YouTube channel The Other Guy. T.O.G. Make sure you check it out. T.O.G. is going to be the nickname for this Pokemon. It's going to be a... it's a Buizel. Buizel with the nickname T.O.G. Tog the Buizel. So let's go ahead and... go ahead and check out this Buizel. Let's see what this Buizel is all about here. So, Swift Swim with timid nature, so it's pretty cool. It's got Aqua Tail and Sonic Boom, which I do know for a fact, Sonic Boom is a move it learns straight away. Aqua Tail, I believe, is an egg move. So, thanks very much, Brian Henshot, for your egg, or this Buizel. So, it's level 11. So, we're going to go ahead and level it up to level 11. And then we've got two more Pokemon to hatch. I think we'll do one more egg and then we'll call an episode. And then you'll see another beautiful grinding montage as always. Just so we can clear all the trainers, make sure our Pokemon are appropriately leveled, and everything else. But we also need to go ahead and decide which Pokemon we're going to teach. Who we're going to teach Rock Smash to, because, or we could use a Pokemon that we have in our PC as a HM Slate. That's the other option that we have as well. I mean, I can't do that. Like, honestly, I reckon the Lapras has always been a HM Slate for me. Like, every time I play X and Y, I make Lapras my HM Slate. But it's not to say that that Lapras is useless by any means. Not at all. I just think that Lapras has that widespread ability to learn different moves. So, let's go ahead and put him, this little Tog, back with the rest of the team. Got a lot of water Pokemon, so I'm guessing I could appreciate the theme of all this here. But let's go ahead and put Tog back in the PC there with the rest of the awaiting Pokemon that could be used in our Let's Plays. But next we're going to replace a level 15 Magikarp. Let's go ahead and get the number randomizer up once again. Once again! And it's going to be number 58. Number 58 was sent in by Feluso Akinwale. So Feluso Akinwale with no nickname. So that is going to be egg number 58. So let's go ahead and put you there. So it's the second last egg because we've already had Angubug, so 58 it is. So we'll be right back once again to see what this egg sent in by Feluso. Thank you very much for your egg. We'll be right back and see what this egg is. Okay, so we're back. We've got our third egg to hatch here, sent in by Feluso Akinwale. Thank you very much, Feluso, for your egg. Your support is greatly appreciated. Let's go ahead and see what this egg is going to be. What is this egg going to be? Cyndaquil! It's a Cyndaquil!
Cyndaquil!
Love Cyndaquil there. Alright, so... actually, another thing, we've had Typhlosion on our modified Egglocke, on our Chililock. And now, it's tied with Rhydon slash Rhydon as our, the most accurate Pokemon in our Let's Plays. I mean, I've got no problems with that. let's go ahead and do a throwback to Chililock. Let's go ahead and call this one Chili. Chili, the type, so, the
Cyndaquil.
Oh, I can't even go that high. My voice is... I've got a man's voice. I can't go that high. Let's go ahead and check out...
Cyndaquil.
Flash Fire. So it's got the hidden ability. Very nice. With Timid Nature, Tackle, Leer, and Extra Sensory. So we don't have a Fire type in this Let's Play. So that is looking pretty nice, to say the least. So we're going to go ahead. We'll level up Cyndaquil. And we'll go ahead, do another grinding montage. Check out all the trainers on our left, on the right, and on the cycling road. So, thank you very much for watching this episode. If you guys enjoyed this episode, go ahead and leave a like down below, because as always, your support is greatly appreciated. In the next episode, we'll go ahead, take on the third gym, and make our way up to the top to see what Team Aqua's up to, because you know that those guys are never up to any good. So, until the next time I see you guys, stay safe, stay sharp, and catch you guys all next time. Later!